Alright, today we're going to be durability testing the Lumia 950 XL, one of the newest phones from Microsoft. Like always, let's jump into the scratch test. I can take my hardness picks and find out where the phone falls on Mohs scale of hardness. The Lumia 950 XL is rocking Gorilla Glass 4, like most other flagship smartphones these days, so it's no surprise when my picks don't leave a mark until level 6, and then a deeper groove on a level 7. You won't have to worry about car keys or coins scratching the screen at all. Testing the camera lens is next. Having a durable camera lens is important to photographers and videographers like myself. Luckily, this lens is just as hard as the front screen, so you won't have to worry about keys or coins scratching the back camera glass either. Now, the back cover of the phone is made of plastic. It is totally removable and replaceable, which is nice. My keys do leave a bit of a mark, and when the razor blade comes out, well, plastic does what plastic does, and it scratches a bit. It looks like the Windows logo is inlaid into the plastic layer, similar to how the older Nexus 6s used to be. Hopefully there aren't any issues with these bits popping out with use later on. On to the burn test. Now this is where things get interesting. I've done tests on more than 10 flagship devices now, and each time the phone will react within a couple seconds to the lighter flame. Whether the pixels will go black and turn off, only to come back on unaffected, like the iPhone 6s and the BlackBerry Priv, other phones will turn white and never come back on like the Nexus 6P or the OnePlus X. But this phone has no impact. I left the lighter in the same spot for over a minute with no reaction from the screen. Very impressive when compared to all of the other smartphones. Hit that thumbs up button for the most impressive burn screen yet. Now onto the bin test. I'll be 100% honest. When I unboxed this thing, I thought for sure it was going to be a casualty. I was all ready to stick it on my shelf next to the bent HTC M9 and my twin Nexus 6Ps. But surprisingly enough, this thing survived. It has an overall inexpensive or cheap feel to it, but it can stand up to the pressure. It flexes more than any other phone though. If you look inside the device, you can see the removable super rigid battery. I imagine that this is the main component giving the phone its strength, similar to the LG G4. Well, there's not near enough carnage in this video, so let's jump inside the device and tear down that water cooling copper bit and see what's inside. Now, this has intrigued me more than any other aspect of the phone. Liquid cooling in a smartphone. So theoretically, the box-looking component at the bottom is the evaporator, where the liquid heats up and moves up the condenser pipe to cool down, then moves back to the evaporator again to repeat the process, effectively cooling down the device and its processor. So in Microsoft's Lumia 950 XL announcement video, they clearly state that the phone has liquid cooling.
And the 950 XL, which uses the octa-core, we use the latest Qualcomm technology, and we push that technology to every limit possible. We push it by using tablet-class liquid cooling.
But in the Microsoft Store, they don't list it as one of the specifications of the phone. It's just not there. You would think they would want to brag about it if it was a real thing. So I decided to see if it was indeed a real thing. Turns out there isn't any liquid inside. Don't get me wrong, having a huge copper heatsink is great for this phone, but it's definitely not liquid cooling. Don't trust everything you read on the internet, kids. Here on Microsoft's support page, they have answered my same question with this. The heat pipe design that is based off of a traditional liquid cooling system. It seems like a semi-evasive answer to the question. Either way, there is clearly no liquid inside the device. I'd love to hear your thoughts on the subject. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Thanks a ton for watching. Hit that subscribe button. Hope to see you around.